Baltimore, Julian.
Yeah?
Why is that?
You see lots of interesting things and people, like Anna Lavery.
Anna Lavery is here? How do you know it was her?
From the photograph that Mike and George sent me.
Where is she?
She was coming out of one of those luxury hotels along the beach.
Did you follow her?
Yep, right down that long, dusty road down to the docks where they rent boats.
Nah, she can't.
Yeah, she did. She has to be taken to the island.
How the hell did she find out he was there?
Woman's intuition.
She's got to be stopped. I can't allow Anna Lavery or anyone else to save this guy while I'm so close to destroying him.
Nobody was in this room. I'm really sorry. Yeah, I was looking for some magazines. Do you have anything to read? My name's Elaine Pinchot.
Please.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to upset you.
No. She was upset over her father's death, of course.
Upset in what way?
Well, she was crying. At times she's been hysterical, disoriented. It's probably why she wandered off.
Wandered off?
Yes. She, disappeared from a room one day. But fortunately, we found her a short time later.
Where?
In an old abandoned section of the hospital.
Can you show me where that is?
Of course.
If you kill me, you know that.
Maybe. But at least I'll have the satisfaction of knowing you don't have them either. Now.
Help! What are you doing?
Oh, it's just not quite sharp enough. Where are the diamonds, Lucy?
I'm not telling you. I'm not telling you.
Just say goodbye.
No, no, wait. Maybe we can make a deal.
Deal?
Yeah.
I'm listening.
Okay.
Maybe I could share the diamonds with you.
Oh, share?
Yeah, like, I could consider you giving, and you could get, like, maybe one or two diamonds, maybe?
It's all or nothing.
No, they're my diamonds. It's not fair. Not fair.
All right, let's see.
No.
It's all over.
No.
Isn't it?
No.
It's all over.
Did you hear something?
No.
Nobody ever uses this place?
No, it's been abandoned for years.
Is there any other way back to the main building apart from the way we came?
Absolutely not. You know, frankly, I'm amazed that Olivia was able to get by security when she got lost down here that time.
Never underestimate Olivia Jerome.
Shut up!
What's that?
Well, it's probably rats. I'm told there are a lot of them down here.
Listen, from here on in, keep someone posted outside of her door.
Well, do you really think that's necessary?
I'll sleep a lot better.
I suppose you're right. Olivia could get hurt if she wanders off down here again.
Sorry I couldn't wait for you. The guards threw me off the island.
Well, that's okay. I managed to get into the man's room.
Did you find out anything?
No. I just started looking around and he came in.
He found you in his room?
It's okay. Nothing happened. I mean, he didn't really do anything. He just gestured for me to leave.
Look, Anna, if this is the mobster that actually killed Victor, now I'm sure he doesn't want to be identified by anyone.
Oh, I couldn't identify him. I mean, he had all these bandages on his face.
Well, that means he's there for a identity change. Now, look, this whole thing is much too risky. I'm going to have the launch waiting offshore, and I want you out of that clinic, and I want you out now.
No! I'm not leaving here until I find out who he is.
This guy could be a killer, a murderer.
He's not going to hurt me.
How do you know that?
I don't know.
Olivia, you'll love it. I'll take you. Just get me out of this thing.
Would you really?
Yes, I
swear. Get you're nasty me. To me.
I won't be nasty to you, Olivia. Get me out.
Oh,
come on.
Okay.
Undo
okay.
me. Undo
okay.
me. Good. Good, Olivia. You won't regret it, I swear. Come
I'm
on.
I'm not going to get punished for this, am I?
No. You like presents, don't you?
Oh, I love.
Good. Good. I'll give you lots of presents. Lots and lots of presents. Hurry up, Olivia. He's coming. He's coming. I'll give you lots of things. Okay. I'll give you many presents.
There you go.
You got it.
There you go.
Oh. I'll get out.
Well, it worked like a charm. Well, don't just stand there. Go after her, but be careful. She'll lead us straight to the diamonds.
Thank you. Oh, Dr. Clark, I'm so happy to see you. I got lost again.
Did you, Olivia?
Oh, and it was so scary.
Well, tell me exactly how you did get lost. Wasn't your orderly with you?
Uh-huh, he was. And then, we got separated somehow. It was very confusing.
Olivia!
Yes?
You know you were under strict orders not to leave your unit. Now I'm going to have to report this to Robert Scorpio.
You're dead.
Dead!
What's going on here? What is
this?
Get
out of here!
What? Are you hurt?
No.
I can only pray that my patient is safe somewhere.
Who is he?
I'm not at liberty to answer that.
You tell me who he is.
Who are you to give me such orders?
No, Dr. Silverdale, I'm not who you think I am. My name is Anna Lavery. This is all fake. I'm a private investigator. I'm from New York City.
What are you doing? You better explain yourself.
Yeah, I will. I was here on a case. I think that this man is involved with a murder and stealing some diamonds.
That's great.
Yeah, well, now maybe you can trust me. You can tell me who he is. Don't you think?
On the contrary. Story only raises more questions for me.
Dr. Silver, please. We have to find out where he's gone. We have to find out who's responsible for this.
You expect me to believe anything you say? You lied your way into my clinic to begin with.
I know. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. That's just the nature of the business I'm in.
It's also the nature of the business of assassins. For all I know, you could have been responsible for this ambush.
No, Mrs. Doctor, still...
I'm calling the police.
Mr. Donnelly's room, please.
I should have called Commissioner Scorpio immediately. Now, you had every opportunity just now in my office to tell me the truth, and you chose not to.
I told you the truth. I can't help it if you don't believe me.
Well, you've lost all your privileges, Olivia. You remain in your room at all times.
Dr. Clark, I'm here for the pickups. Hello again, Olivia.
Hi, I'm having a lovely day.
The nurse at the desk has the list of the patients and the staff members you'll be picking up.
All right, thank you. Sorry.
This isn't fair.
The discussion's over, Olivia.
Great.
I'm calling Robert Scorpio right now.
I hope his line's busy. Why am I in this place? Child, damn! Oh, I can't stand it here anymore. Oh. What are you doing here?
Nobody saw me, don't worry.
It is not okay. You're supposed to have followed Lucy.
Put a lid on it, will you?
I beg your pardon.
Look, her car, my car broke down. She hitched a ride. What am I supposed to do? Hitch a ride after her and say, follow that car?
Yes, you're supposed to hitch a ride after her, follow that car, and end up in Port Charles with
That's
her.
That's impossible.
That's not impossible. You've got to get there. Oh, I can't believe you did this. Colton Shore is here. You've got to get on that helicopter. Get on the helicopter, get on that flight, and get to Port Charles with him.
All right.
All right, Emilio, stay away from Dr. Clark. I had to tell her that I got separated from my orderly.
She believed you?
No. She committed me to my room for the rest of my life.
Sorry.
It's all right. It's worth it. I want those diamonds at any cost.
Everybody. Okay, thank you.
You bet.
Yep.
You're the chopper pilot, right?
You got it.
How you doing?
Fine.
I'm one of your passengers.
Well, good. Okay.
Why don't you just order Dr. Silver to give me the information that I need?
The doctor has committed no crime, and he's the only person that I could vouch for as of this moment.
Your insinuations are a little out of line, my friend.
I'm afraid you are the one who's out of line, my friend. Since I've already asked you to leave the premises the first time you were here, I will not breach my professional ethics. A patient's identity is confidential.
If you will excuse me,
I will search the grounds.
You do that.
Dr. Silver, you realize that you're hiding behind your so-called professional ethics to protect a criminal.
You have given me no proof of this, and I have had enough of your accusations.
Well, I've had enough of this, too.
What are you doing? This clinic is private property.
Don't touch me!
You could be sent to jail for this.
I don't care if I'm sent to jail. That's how committed I am to what I'm doing. I don't care.
I don't know what to believe.
Look, my husband was killed by these people. I've been trying for years to put a stop to them. All I want is a little information.
All right, look, there was a man here last week asking questions.
What did he look like?
Well, he was a handsome man, black hair, brown eyes, medium build.
Doctor, that's very kind of you to tell us that much. We appreciate it.
Yes, thank you. We're very grateful.
Well, I think the doctor would be very grateful if we just left, so...
Yes.
So why not? Excuse me.
Right.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Robert, I promise you I don't have a scratch on me. It all lasted less than a minute.
Yeah, well, Mardi Gras time is over. I want you back here, and so does your daughter.
I know. I'll make it up to her, I promise. Did you get any news on the jewel robbery?
Well, we're working on a major development at the moment. Seems that Victor Jerome's former valet is playing footsie with Olivia at Pine Circle. Now, you can be damn sure that if anyone is connected to the theft of those diamonds and Victor's murder, it's got to be Emile.
Oh, okay, now listen to this. We can verify that Julian's been snooping around Dr. Silver's clinic up here.
It's a tad unsettling. It's starting to sound as if Julian may have succeeded his father as head of the mob.
Yeah, that's one scenario.
All right, I'll give you another one. You could have been killed in that shootout. Now, I want you back here. I want you home, all right?
I will. I promise. You know what? I might come home with some information that can help everyone.
Would you care to elaborate on that? I guess not.
Now, look, honey, I am an old friend of Olivia's, and I just need a moment of her time to...
Listen, I've already told you. She has been placed on restriction. And that also means no phone calls. I'm sorry.
So am I.
Bad news, Julian.
Tell Father to sit down.
What happened? The raid was a failure. It's obvious Duke was onto us. We were shooting at pillows wrapped in gauze.
Duke must have been in the building somewhere.
We were going to search the clinic, but some woman interfered.
Describe her to me.
She was slight, medium height, dark eyes, black hair.
She kicked in a panel of one of the doors like a black belt.
Anna Lavery. So do you think Anna and Duke could have found each other?
I hope not.
It doesn't matter. I'll find them. Kill them both if I have to.
So Julian was snooping around the clinic because he wanted to kill the man he feels is responsible for his father's death, right?
Well, if you think that's true, I'd take Robert's advice, get out of the crossfire and get the hell out of here.
Julian always hated violence.
Yeah, well, honey, times are changing all the time.
I mean, he came to Port Charles because he wanted to get away from the mob and crime and everything. That's what he
said.
But,
Anna, just because he said it doesn't make it so.
I mean, I understand how he feels. If he thinks he can find the person that killed a member of his family, I mean, I really understand how he feels.
Yeah, I can understand it, too. But I think we're closer to our goal than we thought. Look. Yeah, patient, room number 15. Daniel Lund.
Daniel Lund.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, great. We'll put this through the WSB computer when we get home. This means that Daniel Lund killed Julian's father.
At least the trip wasn't a total loss. We have a name.
This
basket. I don't understand. Why did I get this note under my door? I mean, who's trying to warn me?
Maybe they're not trying to warn you. Maybe they're trying to get rid of you so you won't interfere.
Well, I am interfering. And I'm not leaving Rio until I get some more information on this man, Daniel Lang.
Please, please listen to me. I thank God I was able to help you escape that attack. But you must remain here. The people who are after you, they won't be back. It's too risky for them.
Please, understand this. I'm not worried for myself, but for someone that I love very much.
Is it the woman that was here earlier?
As long as I stay here, she'll come back. I cannot risk putting her in danger.
I'm really worried about you. Your treatment is not completed. It's vital you do not use your vocal cords. It could cause serious damage.
Please don't worry about me anymore. I appreciate all that you've done for me. I could never thank you enough.
Anna, will you please be sensible? You could have gotten yourself killed during that attack yesterday.
I didn't, did I?
No, you didn't. Look, you can follow up this Lund lead from Port Charles. I already sent Tiffany to the airport to get the tickets.
I'm not leaving here until I find that man, Sean.
And just how are you going to do that?
I'm going to talk to Julian.
You're going to what? Are you out of your mind? He was the one who's probably behind that attack.
Well, we don't know that.
Look, if Daniel Lund did kill Victor, the only thing that Julian is out after right now is revenge.
Oh, we've got something in common then.
You may have something in common, but he's not going to talk to you if he thinks that you can connect him to that shooting.
He's going to talk to me.
Find Duke?
No. I got men searching all over this city. It's like he's disappeared.
Well, we may not have to look for him anymore.
Why?
If everything goes right, he'll be dead by 1:30 this afternoon.
Is Anna Lavery checked out? No, don't connect me.
Hello? Anna Lavery, hello?
Hello? Damn it. Why didn't you check out?
Beggar looks like it must be Duke.
If it is, then Julian's walking into a trap.
Listen, I'll go after Julian. Get after that beggar, quick!
Anna.
Hi.
I don't get it.
You looking for Daniel Lund? Why didn't you come in then? Needs to talk about.
Hello, Drew.
Sean? This is a surprise. What are you guys doing down here?
I'm looking for Daniel Lund.
Aren't you?
I don't know if I understand.
Come on, we haven't got all day. We're both after the same thing, aren't we?
I don't know.
I think Daniel Lund is responsible for your father's death. Don't you think that?
Yes.
Who is this guy anyway?
I think he was an associate of my father's.
You never met him?
No. How do you know him?
We managed to track him down by the diamonds he stole from your father.
Yeah. The diamonds. Yeah, I heard that that's what it was all about. So that's
that's why you're looking for him then, for the diamonds.
Well, my husband died stopping people like that. And I don't want Daniel Lund picking up where your father left off.
Right. Well, good. I mean, I'm relieved. I mean, at least we both want to put this guy behind bars, right?
That's the only reason you're after him?
Of course.
You know where he is now?
I had tracked him down to a local plastic surgery clinic. He was trying to change his identity.
Yeah, we found him there too, but he's not there anymore.
Well, yeah, I heard that there's been a shootout. Somebody tried to kill him.
Yes, that's what I heard.
So I lost track of him. I mean, I guess he managed to escape. He's probably out of town by now, probably out of the country.
Do you know anybody that would want him dead?
Oh, well, there were, you know, violent factions of the mob who wanted to avenge my father's death. You know, a lot of people were still very loyal to him.
Weren't you?
Of course I am, Sean. I mean, and I want to see the guy put away, but I'm not going to go around shooting up hospitals. I mean, that's not me. You know that.
Well, what are you going to do now?
Just keep looking for him. What about you?
The same.
Good. I'm really... Actually, I'm glad this is out in the open. I think maybe we can help each other.
Well, maybe.
Well, if I get any information about Daniel Lund, I'll let you know, and...
Oh, and I'll let you know.
Yeah. Look, one way or another, right? We put this guy where he belongs. How's
yeah.
that sound?
Sounds good.
All right. I'll see you later.
Yeah, Julian. See you later. What the hell, you wouldn't have told him about those damn diamonds.
It's okay. I think he's on the level.
I'm not too sure about that.
Hey, there you are. You all right?
Sure. Why shouldn't I be?
I think I spotted Duke.
Where?
In one of the slums, Hound? He was dressed like a beggar. I asked Vinny to follow him, but he lost him.
Beautiful.
Hey, listen, I thought you were being set up. That's why I rushed over.
No, no. See, the note I got was not from Daniel Lund. It was from Anna Lavery.
You mean she's on to you?
No. In fact, it looks like now we're allies.
What do you mean? She's going to help you find Duke?
No, she doesn't even know that Daniel Lund is Duke.
Then why is she going after him?
She told me that whoever killed my father got away with a stash of diamonds.
Diamonds?
Yeah. He must have been planning to use them to pay for his new life.
Listen, I don't like the idea you work with this Anna Lavery. She's a very clever woman.
Sure, she's clever. She's so clever, she's going to help me pay for her own husband's death.
Honey, what have you got in these bags? They weren't this heavy when we first got here.
Well, darling, I did a little shopping while we were here.
What'd you do, buy out the rainforest or something?
I shop, but I'm nervous, and I'm nervous because you told me that you're going to hook up with Julian again. I don't trust the man,
all right,
Sean.
All right.
I think we're doing the right thing by leaving.
I know we are doing the right thing because I agree with Julian. You know, this Lund character probably took off as soon as they hit his hospital room, all right? I just want to get out of Rio, okay?
Okay, there's no real reason to stay anymore. I'd just like to find out who gave me that note.
Yeah. We've got to check out. I told him that we had to check in.
Yeah, yeah, I'll
check my keys. Get my phone calls for
you.
I just wanted to say I was really glad that we talked.
Yeah, me too.
I mean, I think, you know, if we work together, we could really find this guy.
I think so.
Good.
I think so, too.
I'm glad.
Hi,
Tim.
Well, Julian, hi, how are you?
Fine.
You know, gang, we really ought to get to the airport.
Are you leaving now?
Yeah, we're headed back to Fort Charles.
Maybe I should fly back with you. I have no reason to stay here anymore myself.
Okay, well, what is it? We're on the 7 o'clock Global Airways.
Good. I'll go to my hotel and check out, and I'll meet you there.
Have fun.
All right.
Bye. Bellhop, could you handle this situation? I'll meet you out front.
Oh my goodness, you get the feeling. Really miss somebody this trip?
Well, I think her mommy's suffering some of the same problem there.
Yes.
New, huh?
So now you're home for keeps?
Yes, I am, but there's still a little unfinished business, and I got to do it for Duke.
Well, I think Duke would like it if you stayed home where it was safe.
Well,
I know I sure would.
I know, but, you know, I feel I have to do this, you know. It's like the last thing he needs me to do for him, you know what I mean?
Honey, I wouldn't worry about him. Your mommy will stay around for a long time. All of our business is just about finished, right?
I'm glad you're back. You're not going to believe this. Robert arrested Emil for pulling a knife on Colton.
What?
Colton all right?
Oh, he's okay. Frisco took Emil in, and now Frisco and Robert are at the warehouse. They're trying to set up a trap to catch Emil's accomplice with the diamonds.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Robert.
Right, thanks. That was Lewis. Robert just picked somebody up at the warehouse, and they're taking him for questioning.
Why don't we give this thing a rest, huh?
What am I going to do? I'm just going to try and sleep all night, aren't I? No, I want to find out what's
up. Why? Come on. We just spent, 17 hours on the plane coming from Rio? I mean, you're tired. You've been pushing this diamond investigation now 24 hours a day for the past few weeks. I think you deserve a few hours rest, okay?
I don't need any rest. I'm fine.
But, Mom, I haven't even had a chance to talk to you about school or anything.
Oh, darling, I know. This will be over soon, and when it is, we will spend all the time we can together. I promise, all right?
Cross your heart?
Oh, I cross my heart.
Swear.
A pinky swear and I stick a needle in my eye and whatever you want.
You know, wow, we haven't had a chance to spend some time together. You want to make some cookies and just talk girl talk or something?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks.
I'm going to go with you.
I'm not mother of the year.
No, you are not mother of the year, and I'm not worried about Robin. I'm worried about you.
One of these. It is only for pain and will not cloud your reasoning. My God, I've been looking for you everywhere. You're not strong enough to be out in the streets alone. Especially here, in favela. Look, I'm not trying to take you back to the clinic. You were right to leave. The police came afterwards and they were asking more questions. No, please don't. Please. Look, I have a plan. There's a fisherman that I know very well. He lives by the ocean and he speaks English. You could be safe with him.
Don't you understand?
Yeah.
If I'm right about this, then whoever killed Victor is trying to put the mob back together again. I can't allow that to happen, Sean. It would mean that the family won out after all, and I lost a husband for no reason.
I don't think you lost a husband for no reason at all. And if Robert's right, and Emil was the guy who heisted these diamonds, I mean, come on, Anna, use your head. This guy is only Victor's valet. He's not going to end up being head of the mob.
Well, if it was Emil, there are still plenty of questions.
Lord.
I mean, who put that note under my door warning me?
I don't know. We tried to figure that out in Rio, didn't we?
Yeah. Expect you guys back so soon. Anyway.
I'll talk to you a little later about Rio. We understand that you're hosting an interrogation party tonight.
Did you get to the bottom of the case yet?
Well, we've cracked a portion of it. The thief was Victor's valet, Emil. He's the booty.
Hmm. Whoa, whoa.
Oh.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
These are real. These are beautiful. These are incredible. Did you get his accomplice?
Well, apart from the diamonds, I'm not sure what we got.
After you, Lucy.
What are they doing here?
Lucy's dream finally came true. Someone threw diamonds at her feet.
It was in her car. Two guys were chasing her, and then when they got to her car, they threw that pouch into her car.
Lucy, just when did this somebody throw the pouch into your car?
Yesterday.
Yesterday. Benny got a call from a woman a few weeks ago.
Well, you see, Lucy has never seen those diamonds before until yesterday, so she couldn't be this woman that you're talking about.
It could be a totally unrelated incident, Robert.
Maybe. But as I recall, you were concerned about Lucy a few weeks ago because someone had stolen her car. The car then mysteriously turns up out of Pine Circle, where coincidentally Emil just happens to be working.
And you thought that Olivia had sent Emil after Lucy to get to you.
Well, listen, fellas, you gotta understand something. I was a little paranoid, you know. I'm the one that put Victor Jerome away, you know. But Lucy was just on a vacation, you know, for a couple of days, and she came home safe and sound.
Benny did get a call from a woman. But there again, my guess is it was Olivia. Only she has a perfect alibi being locked up at Pine Circle.
Lucy, was there a woman in that other car?
She didn't see anything.
Wait a minute. Let's let Lucy
answer
this question. I mean, you weren't even in the car, as I recall.
Listen, okay? She's traumatized you, all right? We're going to have to relax a little
bit.
It's okay. It's all right. Just get a breath.
It's like Scott told you. I was in the car, and I was too scared, and it happened all really fast. I was just too terrified to notice.
I see. Well, I wouldn't be too quick to eliminate Olivia. I understand they've got a few security problems out of Pine Circle. She has been seen over her room on a number of occasions.
It's okay. All right, listen, I'll put my foot down here. No more questions. All right, we've answered everything that you want to know. She's got to get some rest. She's got to sit down a minute, okay?
Not yet. I wanted to take a look at Emil.
What?
Well, he might have been the guy in the car. Maybe you'll recognize him. We have him in custody. I'm going to bring him up.
It's okay. Sorry. It's only some poor beggar.
The body.
Please try not to talk. He had no identification. That's not unusual here. He will be buried where everyone here in Favela is buried. What you would call Potter's Field. Look, I know there's a lot of dangers for you out there in the world. As you can see, there's a lot of dangers here as well. I think it would be best if you stayed with my friend, the fisherman. And then I could take care of you medically as well.
Appointment for you. But at least she's back from her trip, and before too long, you'll be able to spend lots and lots and lots of time with her. She can tell you about Rio. You can tell her about your friends and school.
Not much of that. Mom doesn't talk about normal stuff anymore. She seems to be spending all her time thinking about Duke.
Well, that's just because the case that she's working on involves Duke's enemies.
Yeah, I know. The people who killed him. But you see, I don't want that happening to my mom, too.
You and I have a lot in common.
We do?
Mm-hmm. I didn't want him to join the police force.
Nobody wants the people they love doing dangerous work because it's very scary. It sure is. You know what I do? I always just try to remember what a great cop he is, and you can do the same thing, because your mother's a very good cop.
Yeah, she is.
Okay, it's bedtime. Gotta get some Z's.
Yeah, that's right, Felicia.
You know who I mean.
Well, can I just stay up a little longer, just until my mom gets home?
Well, you've got your hair to brush, your teeth to brush, pajamas to get into, and clothes to hang up.
Why don't you get ready for bed, and I'll call over at police headquarters and see what's going on, okay?
Okay. Felicia, thank you very much for keeping me company.
It was my pleasure.
I'm glad we're friends.
Me too.
I'm going to go
thank
put
you.
My pajamas on.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a couple of these babies could give somebody a lifetime of pleasure, huh?
There aren't many people that would give up diamonds like these. I mean, I must say, Lucy, I'm impressed.
Well, how much about do you think they're worth?
An awful lot. An awful lot. I mean, these are beautiful diamonds. They're blue, white, perfect, all of them. I mean, I don't have my jeweler's glass with me right now, but they really are perfect.
Okay, Lucy. Does this man here look familiar?
Yes. Is this the man that threw the diamonds into your car?
I told you I don't know anything about any diamonds.
Shut up, nobody asked you.
Well, I didn't mean that he was. I just mean I do recognize him from the flyers that were passed around at the hospital.
Then you can't really be sure that he was the man in the car.
No, like I told you, I was too scared to notice anyone. But I think if I had seen him, I would have known his face from the flyer.
So you don't think that this was the man in the speeding car that was there when the diamonds were tossed, right?
No, I would have remembered his face if I'd seen it.
Tagging back to his cell.
Those the diamonds you're talking about? Doesn't look like much of a haul to me, unless you cops have already taken a taste.
Get him out of here, will you?
Yes, sir. I want to call my lawyer.
Yeah, let him make his call and lock him up. You two can leave as well. But don't make any travel plans. I want you back here again so that we can go through this story in greater detail.
Well, you know, we told you everything we know.
Yeah, well, perhaps after everybody's calmed down a little bit, maybe you'll remember something which will be of use to us.
Okay. All right, Robert. We'll try. Come on. Thank you, Frisco.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my hat. Excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be the first to speak.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think they're telling us everything they know.
Yeah, but it's also hard to believe that they'd be at the center of a diamond heist. Come on.
Well, look, I'm going to have to go home. There's a woman waiting there, and I don't think she even remembers what I look like, so... If you need anything, call, all right?
Yeah. See you later.
Bye.
That's good advice, Anna. Let's take off, huh?
Are you crazy?
Are you crazy? If Emil is involved with this, then we, all three of us, have to start thinking of ways to question him to get the truth out of him.
We'll get him, Anna.
When? When they set up a new mob and they start killing people again? Oh, great.
Look, no one's going to put the Jerome family back in business tonight, okay? Now, we're not going to break Emil's story while we're all exhausted and strung out. We go home, get some rest, you be with your daughter, and we'll talk about this tomorrow.
Yeah, you got that right. And we're going to keep talking until I have all my questions about this case answered.
Bloody hell, was she like this in Rio?
Oh, worse. I mean, I don't know what the hell's wrong with her. I mean, she even let Julian convince her that he was on our side, which I doubt he is.
Does that mean that you buy the theory that someone's trying to put the Jerome family back together again?
Look, Robert, the only thing I know for sure is that, I mean, she is becoming totally obsessive about this case. Now, we both know that she is a first-rate investigator, but in this one, she's letting her emotions rule her head. I'm very worried about her, that's all.
Well, maybe I ought to go over there and have a chat to her. Do you think it'll help?
No. But I think you should try.
Camille confess?
I didn't come here to talk about you.
I hope you're not expecting an apology from me.
Sean, maybe, but I was married to you. I got into the abuse.
I don't mean to be horrible. I don't know what comes over me sometimes.
Well, that's why I'm here. Lately, you seem to be driven. I don't think it's good for you. Robin either, for that matter.
Oh, she's all right. Robin's all right. I was just away for a little trip, that's all. This is going to be better for all of us in the end, I promise.
Really?
Yes. I'm not letting them start off again. Not after what we've been through.
I don't buy it. There's something more going on here.
I'm just doing what I do. I investigate criminals.
And not very effectively. This case is clouding your judgment and it's eroding your instincts.
No, it is not.
Rumor has it you've made an ally out of Julian Jerome. You've even shared aspects of this case with him. Do you realize how preposterous that sounds? Not to mention dangerous.
I think he's after the same thing.
It's too soon in the game to tell what he's after.
It's the same thing, Robert. Something happened in the clinic. I can't explain it, but I felt very close to the truth there.
Close doesn't count in court. Facts do.
You know, I felt that Duke was there with me. He was there with me and he was urging me on to keep searching, to keep looking for this thing.
Are you listening to this? Do you realize how this sounds?
I don't care how it sounds, Robert. You understand. You do. Now, there is something I have to find out, and I am going to.
Suit yourself. Maybe I'll help you in this manhunt for this fictitious person who you think is about to rebuild the Jerome family again.
Thanks.
Well, I'm not doing it for nothing. I want a favor. You accept that I have those diamonds and that there's no way that they can be used to influence or finance any criminal activity. At least get some rest.
I'm all right, Robert. I'm all right.
Maybe you're onto something. Maybe there is something going on. Maybe not. Just remember, Sean and I care about you.
You kiss on the cheek. But you were fast asleep. So what woke you up then?
Just a stupid dream.
Oh, yes?
It was a nightmare. Except it didn't have monsters.
Why was it a nightmare?
Because I was all alone. And I didn't know why. But then, all of a sudden, I did know. Nothing told me or anything, I just knew.
How did you know that you were all alone?
Well, something gone. Something came and it took Duke away. And then it came back and it took you and Daddy away too.
Oh, that was just a dream, darling. I know it was horrible, but it was a dream, okay?
I know, but except for the part about Duke.
You know, what happened to Duke, that doesn't mean that that's going to happen to your father and or to me. It doesn't mean that. You do understand that, don't you?
But you guys always do dangerous stuff.
Not all the time, darling. And we know what we're doing. We're very careful, you know, we're very careful.
I know. But sometimes I'm just so afraid of what might happen to you.
Muito bom.
Senhor.
Obrigado.
On the list of calls you're allowed to take. Mr. Broxton, so nice to hear from you.
Hi. Emil just called me. He asked me to pass on a message since he can't contact you directly.
I understand. Where is he?
He's in jail.
He's what?
Yeah.
Where? How did that happen?
Frisco Jones picked him up. He got in some kind of a fight.
Oh, how intelligent of him.
Mm. I'm afraid I have some even worse news for you.
Oh, what's that?
Scott Baldwin and that Lucy Coe Jones woman have turned the diamonds over to the authorities.
They what?
Yeah. Emil wasn't really sure what they were up to, but he said that he checked out the diamonds they handed to the police. And he said that they held back at least 10 of the largest and most valuable stones.
Oh, good. How considerate of them.
Yeah. Well, Emil wants to know what he should do now.
Nothing. From now on, I think I'll handle the situation myself. You see, that property is mine, and I intend to get it back.
Well, it's been a pleasure working with you. Anyway, Dr. Kloster, I just wanted to say goodbye because this is going to be my last run up from General Hospital.
Really?
Are they assigning you to another service?
Oh, no. I'm leaving Port Charles for good. I'm relocating somewhere else.
Good luck, Mr. Shaw.
All right. Thanks.
Good afternoon, Olivia.
Hi, Colton.
I just want to say goodbye, actually.
Oh, no, just a minute. Would you mind? I know it's time for our session, but could I please just speak with Colton just for a moment? Just a moment.
It's hardly a regular, Olivia.
I know. But I couldn't help but overhear your conversation, and I think it might be my last time to find out about my friends in Port Charles.
All right. But just for a moment.
Thank you.
I'll be right outside the door.
Okay.
Thank you.
So you wanted to ask me about your friends in Port Charles?
Yes, if you don't mind. I get so little news.
Tom Hardy, you'd know, of course. He and Simone had a baby recently. It was a boy.
Oh.
I have a feeling this isn't really what you wanted to hear about, but I know.
Is there any news about the investigation into my father's death?
Oh, Olivia, I don't really think it's my place to talk about
it. Please. I'm just desperate. They won't let me see a newspaper here. They think it'll upset me.
Well, I'm sure that they know what's best for you.
No, they don't. What's upsetting is not knowing anything. Have you heard anything at all?
I did actually hear. Well, I know that your father's valet, Emil, he was arrested recently. But you probably know that because he worked here, right?
No. He was arrested?
Mm-hmm.
Well, did they know anything? Did he say anything?
Olivia?
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, but I don't have a lot of time.
Okay. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Good luck to you.
Thank you. Same to you.
You bet.
Bye.
Okay, thanks.
I'll be right back.
Okay.